Hello, welcome to Ceramics with Miss Tomimitsu. Over the course of the next few weeks, we are going to be making teapots using the magical method of coiling that you see here. So this is an example of a vessel that I started. And a teapot has seven parts. First part is the vessel. The next part is the handle. You'll also want to, and the handle can be an over-the-top handle. It can be directly across from the spout, which is the third part. So you have the choice of that. You can even have a hollow coil handle that sits about at a 45 degree angle across from the spout. But for this purpose, we're going to make probably an over-the-top one. You also will have a foot. And I have a nice half inch foot here that gives my pot, and it's a little smaller than the first foot of the pot. So it gives my pot nice lift, and that'll help for glazing purposes all the way. Also, so you can glaze all the way down. We also have three parts of the lid, and that's the main part of the lid that protects and keeps your tea warm. Then you have the flange that protects, that makes the lid, or prevents the lid from falling off. And then you have a decorative knob just for opening the lid. So all of these parts are in between plastic and leather hard stages, so they're not ready to join yet. But this pot will get joined, and you hopefully will get to see the preview of that or see the video of that. But for today, we're gonna start just by making our initial foot and foundation. Okay, so these are the tools that you'll be using. And for the whole project, you'll need some slab sticks because we do slab the base out. It keeps it more watertight. You'll also need a small rolling pin if you're just rolling out for yourself. If you're rolling out for a whole group, like a table, a big slab, you want to use the larger rolling pin. But for video purposes, that rolling pin works out much better, the smaller one. You'll need a couple sponges, okay? And I like to have this smaller sponge. Just for the smaller cleanup jobs, and then obviously our regular sponge. For the foot, you'll always want to make, for ventilation purposes, for thermal ventilation purposes, the foot can't be totally flat. The second foot you add, it can't be just a slab. You have to have some way for ventilation to reach your under your pot. So we will actually eventually cut this in half, is one option, or it can be left together, but it has to have a negative space in the foot. You'll also want a knife and a needle tool as usual, scoring tools as usual, okay? And I have my Taraki chicken sticks and comb. I like this tool a lot, especially if you see the angle of it later on for cleaning up coils. It's a good smearing tool, plus our normal smearing tools that we have, our rib and wood modeling tool. I have a stencil, okay, for our foot and or a foundation's foot. And then we also, for rolling out, we want to roll out on a mat. And this brush is not just for smear, for cleaning up in between coils sometimes, but for smearing. The tip is really good, especially for a spout. So I'm going to sit this to the side, and I'll show you a sample of what day one would look like. Okay, and this is what I'm going to demonstrate right now. So this is just your foundation. I have another one here as well, but just like any house, you have to have a strong foundation. So it's very important that this is very smeared together very well, all of these coils. And the thickness will be a half an inch, okay, for each coil. And eventually, because of shrinkage, they will get smaller. So we're gonna start by laying out our cloth. And you wanna make sure it's nice and flat, no folds, and have a chunk of clay. I'm not going to need this much, so I'm just going to rip off. You'll only need about a square that's about between three quarters and an inch thick. And I can smack slab first a little bit, and then I like to turn my cloth over to keep it dry on the other end when I'm ready to roll. And I'm going to lay down the two sticks. And they're just measuring sticks that measure a quarter inch thick each. So when they're combined, you have a nice even half inch. And then I'm gonna take my small rolling pin and just roll out the clay. And it's really easy, and you wanna make sure that you roll it out all the way so they're just rolling right across. Very simple step, and I just always like to go on both sides. Okay, done with my sticks, done with my cloth, can lay those to the side, and I can take out my little pink stencil. And this is measures about just under 4 inches. And that's real, we have stencils around the room for you to use. That's a really good size for the base of your teapot. There are larger stencils, but you don't want to go any smaller than that. And even when you do the larger ones, you want to be very careful because you don't want to get your teapot too wide, because you don't want it to end up being too heavy, because you have to still fill it with water and be able to hold it with one hand when it's useful. Now, when I cut, did you notice that I did not cut at an angle? I cut straight at a 90-degree, you know, cut, not like a 45-degree angle. And if you get a little bit of angle there, no problem at all. You just take your handy-dandy sponge and you want to, and I'll bring this into the picture. You want to always, anyway, with it wringing out a lot of the water, you want to always round out anything you slab out with a sponge, because you don't want any sharp edges. And that's the difference with having something that looks more professional, more skillfully created, more skillfully crafted, rather than some willy-nilly thing. So I have this nice base, and I forgot to show you a couple other things, or one other thing you're gonna need. You're gonna need our plastic disc we have in class to lay this on. So I'm just gonna lay it right there. And I like to put it on the spiky edge. It just helps it prevent from sticking, okay? So we're gonna move the water to the side, put this here, and we're gonna roll some coils. So we can start those first 2 to 3 coils you need for your base. And you'll see on this one, I had 3. So when you roll a coil, you wanna have, and I'm gonna move everything out of the way, you wanna have lots and lots of space. I prefer to stand when I roll my coils. You know, that's up to you, you know, whatever gives you the best control. But you want to definitely make sure you moisten the table. It's not slippery wet. It's just kind of moistened, just like your hand should be moistened, so that you, your clay, your coil doesn't get dried out while you're coiling. So I have some clay here. I'm just gonna make a couple little balls, and actually, you know, I'm gonna make about 3 balls with this. You want them about, I don't know, like golf ball, between a golf ball and a ping pong ball size. So you start with a ball, then make it into like a little nugget, okay? And my hands are getting kind of really dirty, so I'm gonna just dip them in my water and wipe them off my apron, but keep them wet. And just roll the coil using 2 hands. The biggest mistake I see students use, they're trying to do it with one hand and they're like, oh, I can't do it right. But you just wanna roll it and just go for it. Have a growth mindset. And you'll notice I'm kind of smacking it on the side somewhat. When that happens, it's because one side got flatter than the other. And if that occurs, just smack it, okay? And I'll show you, it's really easy. If one part of your coil gets thicker than the other, ignore the thin parts and just roll the thick parts. And you want a round coil, okay? So it's about the same thickness all the way through, round, not flat on one end. If you get a flat coil and it gets too thin, it's not really usable. I'm gonna slice it at like a 45-degree angle, and I'll put that to the side. I'm gonna go ahead and make another. Okay, again, a ball, then a nugget, and then the magic happens. You just roll to get a nice round coil. Okay, that's all the same thickness throughout, and that's about between 1/4 inch and 1/2 inch, closer to the 1/2 inch mark. And we have some Crayola markers in the room, and I asked the students, let me grab one, that is the best kind of example for how thick, about the thickness of it. So mine are a little bit thinner, but about the thickness of these Crayola markers. And in my classroom, we'll have one on every table. I'm gonna do this one a little thicker because it's gonna be the first one. And I'm really happy with my coils. They're lovely little coils. And I have my base again. So I'm gonna cut that at an angle to start. I'm just gonna take water and put water here. Because we're smearing so well, we don't have to score and slip necessarily. I just wanna make it a little wet so it sticks. And when I lay the coil on top, not next to, on top the slab that I made, if you make that angle, your coil just rides up the side like a little escalator ride, and then lays down on the other part of the coil, okay? Now, you want to always cut these little ends off because you'll end up getting negatives or getting an air bubble. And also it helps, again, for the escalator ride for the next coil. So This one is a little thicker, so I'll go to the second thickness coil. I'll cut it at an angle. And I cut a little bit more off there because it was a little thick on the end. And let me zoom in. I'll kind of line up these two 45 degree angles together really nicely. And after I lay this on here, before I go to the next one, I'll just take my finger and smooth that. It'll end up looking like one coil. Use the back of my nail and my finger, which is our best tools, right? Always on hand. Haha. Okay, so I like this one. This is a good foundation. And I have three coils up for the most part, you know, on it. So it's a great foundation, very sturdily built. I'll go ahead and smear here a little bit. Now, this is the part you need to always add a small reinforcement coat. So I'll just take my scraps I have here, kind of give them a little quick wedge together. And I'm gonna make, like I told my students, a dirty little earthworm, just so you remember. Very, very skinny for my reinforcement coil. You don't want anything thick. So like a tiny little dirty earthworm. You would never make all your other coils this thin and sloppy. But on this one, it can be thin and sloppy. And you just lay it inside where the floor, and you wanna really push in there with your finger so you don't get air bubbles, but where the floor meets the wall. And I'll just break it off there. And I'll push some more. And now I'm going to use some little bit of pinching techniques to open it up, and then some serious smearing. So I love this tool, it's my favorite tool for serious smearing. It's a wood modeling tool. The rounded part of it can just go up the wall from the reinforcement coil, just right before the reinforcement coil, and smear up the wall if you have it a little moistened. You don't want it too drippy, just moistened, have the tool. And go all, ride my tool all the way up the wall. And you can see, oh, I'm almost done. I have some more here. You have serious smearing. It's a little rough still, but for the most part, the coils are smeared together. So I need to just do a little bit more smearing. And now kind of go sideways. And you always want to make sure to hold your non-dominant hand, hold onto the outside of the clay so that you're not stretching the clay too much so it doesn't lose its integrity and the coils don't start falling apart. But you can start to stretch it a little bit. That's okay. It thins out the clay a little bit, which is good because again, you don't want too heavy of a pot. And on the outside, it still looks good. You might have a little bit of stretching here. And again, these aren't cracks, they're just stretch marks. And you can just take your dry finger or moist, not really dry, but just a little bit of moistened finger and wipe the outside of the coil if you see stretch marks. It's something that you don't want to drive yourself batty trying to fix constantly. It can be fixed at the end, okay? So I like this. It's just a little rough, so I'll take my sponge and I'll try to get a lot of water out of my sponge, squeeze it, lay it inside. It's the perfect sponge size, guys. Which is exciting. And I'm stretching the clay a little bit more too. But we want this nice and smooth because when you go to wash your pot, you're gonna be putting your hand down in there. And if anything is kind of like lumpy bumpy right now, that could be sharp later when this is a rock. So you really want it, you know, as smooth as I have my samples here inside. Maybe they even need some more smoothness. And the whole pot inside has to be this smooth. On the outside, you want those beautiful coils to show. So, because what's the point of making a coil pot if you smear all your coils in? But you want the inside coils smeared so it's watertight and smooth so you don't cut yourself. And the outside coils, you notice how I'm stretching? You want those outside coils to show. So I'm kind of stretching the clay right now by pinching. And that's another technique just to open it up. I'm not pinching hard, I'm barely even touching. And my fingers aren't inside actually, it's just my thumbs. Okay, so I've opened it up a little bit. So now I can start stacking coils. And eventually I can stack coils to be more creatively. But you always want that nice foundation at the bottom, and then you can get creative. This is one that I'm in the middle of working on. I did a rainbow. I made this whole piece flat on the table and then smeared the inside, and then I added it to the pot. And the same thing for this flower design, or sun, maybe sunburst design. I built it all together on the table first, in separate parts, and then smeared them together and then added them later on, okay, after that, while they were still very plastic, not leather heart. So we have a great foundation. Here's two, three examples now. One, two, three examples of how to start your foundation. So look for the next videos where we learn to roll some more coils to make some amazing designs. And then we'll have how to make your foot, your handle, your lid, and your spout. Thanks for watching. Have a wonderful day. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks. Bye.